Hello creators, my name is Anne, and today I'm going to show you how to make realistic iridescent or rainbow reflective material. I will tell you how it works in real life and how to make it in Cloth3D using the iridescence material type. So what is a reflective material? It is a type of material that reflects the light in low light or dark conditions. It is made from the basic fabric and a tiny glass bead coating that is adhered to the fabric. Most surfaces scatter the light, that's why they are not so visible in the night time. Reflective materials, on the other hand, reflect the light back to the light source. This is called retroreflection. Cloth3D allows us to create an iridescent reflective material that shows us different colors at different angles. Let's see how it works and apply the iridescence material to this simple square piece of fabric. Add a new material in the object browser, click on Add button, and apply it, drag and drop it. Then make sure to select this material and go to the property editor to customize it. Cloth3D applies a general material type to it, fabric matte. This material type allows us to make a huge variety of fabrics and adjust them with texture maps and other parameters here. However, there are some materials that you can't make with it, for example reflective. Click on fabric matte and you will see a bunch of other materials, or how it's also called, shaders. Basically, each shader is a set of instructions that say to the render engine how to interpret and render the material surface. I will not explain shaders in detail in this video, just remember that you need to select the iridescence shader to have the reflective material. The effect of this shader is only visible in the render window, so let's open it. Go to the render tab, render, and turn on interactive render, this button. This is how it looks by default. My camera is located right in front of the square. To have it, press number 2 on a keyboard or right-click somewhere in a 3D window, front view. So now we see only the blue color, but if you start rotating the camera, you will see the other colors one by one, like a rainbow. Here is the smooth transition to the green color. Then it goes white, pink, and red. Looking at different angles of this material, you will see different colors. You can adjust these colors in the property editor. Select the material and go to the very end of the material properties. You will find the iridescence properties. These colors define what color you will see on the fabric in a render window. You can notice that the order is the same as we see here. The first one is blue, the color in front of us, and the right angle, then green, white, pink, and red. Let's apply this material to something more complicated than just a square. For example, these shorts. Here you can see all the colors together. This gathering at the waistband creates folds that we see at different angles. The colors gradually change as the angle of view changes. We see a blue color at a right angle, at the most even part of the fold. Then the fold goes inside and we can see a gradation from green to red. It goes back and we see a reverse gradation from red to blue. When we rotate the camera, we start seeing the other areas at right angles. For example, at the back we see this area blue, because we look at it at a right 90 degrees angle. Hope it is clear. Let's create our own rainbow fabric now. I found this jacket that has a similar rainbow effect but a different color sequence. In front of us, at the right angle, we can see a green color. Then it goes blue, pink, yellow, and black. Let's repeat this order here. Click on the first color and select the green color. Then select the second one and make it blue. The next one will be pink, this one yellow, and the last one black. Here we go. Now it is correct, but you can notice that the colors are too faded. It is because we have a white base color on the shorts. I found out that the iridescent fabric on this jacket looks dark gray in the daylight. So let's darken it. Click on the color icon here and select the color. I think this gray is enough. Now it looks better, but still not so bright. We can increase the weight value here. It looks like it's a contrast and brightness parameter. I will increase it to get a pure black color like on the jacket, something about 0.85. Then let's adjust the roughness. I don't like these glossy areas, so I will increase this value. Also, the rougher surface gives us a smoother transition between colors. And finally, you can change the hue value and experiment with different color combination. I will leave it at 0 for now. And that's pretty it. We have a rainbow-looking reflective material similar to this one on the jacket. The only problem is that in the real life we see all these reflected colors in low light conditions. But here we can make them visible even in a studio light. In order to make this fabric look realistic, you can either create a low light environment, changing light properties in the render window, or decrease the weight parameter to make it less bright in daylight or studio light. Keep it in mind. The last thing that I want to mention is that you won't be able to export this material to another software. Cloth3D uses a V-Ray render engine that has its own shader system. I believe you can set up a pretty similar material in another software with V-Ray, but I haven't tried that. If you have, please share your experience in the comments. If you want to render with a different render engine, for example Cycles, it's a Blender render engine, you will need to create a completely new material with the Blender shader system. Although you can still render it in Cloth3D. So, wish you great renders and see you in the next videos. Bye!